A scientific report is formatted into four main sections. Now, depending on your assessment outline, you can also have an extra section at the beginning and an extra section at the end. Most scientific reports follow the IMRaD format. That's an introduction, methods, results, and discussion. At the beginning, you can also sometimes have what's called an abstract, and that's essentially a summary of your entire scientific report. And then depending on your outline, you can also have a conclusion section, which again is also a summary of your entire scientific report. The reason why I say sometimes there's a conclusion section is depending on your discipline, a discussion and conclusion section are sometimes combined together. And they can also have another name, for example, summary. So you just need to make sure that you definitely check your assessment outline to find out if you need one of those. Now, each of these sections has a series of key elements or factors that you'll need to incorporate into each one to make sure that you get the marks allocated for each section of your scientific report. I've made a separate video for each of these sections so that you can just follow it and then you can write that section for yourself. So I'll pop the links to those videos in the description below, but I'm just going to explain what each of these sections are now for you. The first section, that optional abstract, is that summary of your whole scientific report. And what that does is it takes sentences, essentially, from your introduction, your methods, your results, your discussion, and your conclusion, and that's what makes up the abstract. So it doesn't come from somewhere else. You don't need to come up with new material when you're writing your abstract. You'll have already written your scientific report before you go anywhere near your abstract. Don't start with that first. Then you're going to have your introduction. And again, number one rule of scientific writing is never start writing your introduction first, ever. Your introduction is one of the hardest things to write, and it's where you connect the study that you've done, whatever it may be, like an experiment, or maybe you've gone out and collected data for something. Whatever your study is, you then need to connect that with a real world context. So why is it important? Why does it matter to anybody? Has it filled a knowledge gap, or does it have practical applications? That's what your introduction is. And that's quite complex. If you haven't written the rest of your report, by writing the rest of your scientific report, it will literally give you the information and the references you need to write your introduction. So never start writing your abstract first and never start writing your introduction first. The next section is your methods, and that is the first section that you want to start with. Why? Because it's the easiest. Your methods section is literally just you recording down what you have already done. That's it. So that's what your methods is. All you need to do in your methods section is write your recipe for a chocolate cake, except in this case, your chocolate cake is a scientific study. Imagine that somebody else is going to read your methods section and want to copy it and get the same results you did. That's what you're going to write down. After you've written your methods section, you then write your results. Now, the key thing here is that when you write your results, you're writing your data, so it's usually numbers. Never ever write what they mean. So your results are also really easy to write because you're not figuring anything out. You've already done your science. You'll have documented somewhere, probably in Excel, what your results are, and all you're doing is turning that into sentence form. I also find it best to make a graph, some sort of image from your results data, put that in first, and then explain it. That's a great way to write your results. Then you're going to write your discussion. The discussion is probably going to take you the longest out of any of your sections. That's supposed to be the case, because you have to start looking at the literature, at other journal articles that have been published to help you make sense of your data. So all you need to do for your discussion section in general though is take your results, figure out what your key finding is, what are the main things that it tells you, and then that's what you're going to write about in your discussion and explain how that connects or matters. And a great way to do that is simply to compare it to other people's studies and what they've found. Then we come to the conclusion, whether you have one or not, you're essentially summing up what you've said in your discussion. So what's your key finding? Why does it matter? And are there any practical applications? Your conclusion is really short, like it's usually 150 words or less. It's tiny. It really is not something you need to worry about too much or think about too much. And you don't even need the words in summary or in conclusion. You don't need any of that. You just put a heading, conclusion, and then write those few sentences that sum up everything that you've written before that. Now we come back to the introduction. Remember how I said that you'll need to have written the rest of your report to write your introduction? What will have happened when you're doing your research to write your discussion section? You will have come across a lot of key journal articles that you will have cited or referenced in your scientific report. Those papers give you the context you need for that introduction, especially in the beginning, where you're connecting your study with why it matters. So when you start writing your introduction, pop in that key real-world context of why your study matters. And remember, you can read those journal articles again to get that information. A great place to look is their introduction. because they'll have said why it matters and why it's important. And then from there, you're going to detail what your study is, what it's going to do. And a key part of the introduction is that you will include your aims or research questions or your hypothesis statement. In general, in science, we come up with that research question before we go out and we do our study. But usually what happens in your undergrad is you're given it. Right, your lecturer, probably on your assessment outline, has written down what the whole point of the study is, and you'll probably just take it from there and just have to reword it a little bit. And then your scientific report is written, but that's the format of your scientific report. So IMRAD format: introduction, methods, results, and discussion, abstract and conclusions, sandwiching those in there, depending on what your specific assessment is asking for.